Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of our Skyrim Thieves Guild questline. So in the last episode, we got shot by a poison arrow, but it did let us learn that Mercer Frey is actually the super evil one in this. It's not Carlisle at all. She is good, and she's been kind of made to look like the bad guy. But really, she did absolutely nothing wrong. It was Mercer Frey that took down the original leader of the Thieves Guild. So we've got quite a big job now to go back and try and convince everybody else in the Thieves Guild that that's what actually happened. And then hopefully we can start to get some revenge on Mercer Frey. And of course, get that Nightingale armor that we've been waiting for. So let's kick off. Let's do episode 4 of the Thieves Guild and try and spot Evie in the next 2 seconds before we start. So guys, here we are back in Riften. I just thought I'd kind of stand here and look at how pretty it is. Look at those clouds and those mountains and the little god rays. Like, I know I say this a lot, but it's definitely one of those games that you can just stare at and be like, wow, it's so pretty. And look, there's Mjoll looking very pretty with a very crazy and not very practical hair. But never mind, we are heading back to the Thieves Guild. We are going to go set the record straight about poor Carlisle. I have not got loads of mods to show you this time. I've not really updated much since last time, not added loads of new mods. One mod I have added is one that is hopefully going to take the hood off Carlisle so we can see what she looks like. Because the hood that she wears is, That's locked. Okay, I guess we have to go the long way. The hood she wears is kind of weird. It kind of goes really high up on her forehead and it makes her forehead look very tall and strange. Ooh, did you see that lightning then? And I kind of just want to see a little face sheen, even though she's meant to be all sneaky and thiefy. So hopefully, she's going to have it off. But we need to travel now back through the ratway to get back to the Ragged Flagon and set the story straight. Huh? What are you doing in here? I'm not sure you're supposed to be here.
Yes.
Here she is.
I'm glad you're here.
She still has her hood on.
Some of these people are beginning to suspect who I am.
Why have you got your hood on?
I'm ready to face the guild.
I'm ready to face your face. Please take your hood off.
I'm not sure what to expect when we enter the cistern.
Okay, I'm going to try one more thing. There, look! Yes! It worked! Carlisle! Look at me, love! I want to see what you look like!
Time for talk as well.
Yeah, she looks way cooler! If you saw the thumbnail from my last episode, that is the Carlisle from the thumbnail. Look at her doing a little spin. We'll see it even better when we go into the light with her now. Hey Thieves Guild, please don't get too mad. May have brought the person you thought was the traitor back into the realm, but never mind. Oh no. The purple is still there. Okay, come on Carlisle, it's all cool. Lydia, move out the way. They're just letting her walk in. Well done Thieves Guild. You have a very secure entrance there.
You better have a damn good.
Oh, now they're mad. Now they're mad.
Please, lower your weapons so we can speak. I have proof that you've all been misled.
No tricks, Carlisle, or I'll cut you down where you stand.
Don't hurt her. She's a goodie. Look at Vex getting involved. She looks vexed.
I think you'll find its contents disturbing.
Let me see.
Believe her. I'm going to equip my torch so I can see things more clearly. I want to see a little face sheen. There we go. See, she looks cool. She's cool looking.
It's true, Brynjolf. Every word. Mercer's been stealing from the guild for years.
He's been stealing from you, Brian.
There's only one way to find out if what the lass says is true.
Delvin's face is like head,
face.
Why,
just a blessed monk, Bryn. What's in that book? What did he say?
Is she gonna go forward? She is. Her bow and arrow and stuff look pretty badass. I can't wait to get my Nightingale armor. I'm well excited about that. You can't get into the store alone. You need 2 locks to do it. It's one of those like nuclear missile codes. You both need to do that at the same time. So these guys are gonna do it, perhaps.
But the vault's still locked up tighter than a drum. Now use yours.
Mine? Have I got a key? Oh, I thought they were all waiting for me. I'm like, guys, I don't have any keys. They all got taken from me when I got arrested in Markarth.
gone. Everything's gone.
Look at this! He's robbed them blind! Oh, you guys! You guys! You got robbed!
He's all gone.
You got robbed!
Son of a bitch!
Oh yeah, Vex is Vex. Look at her go.
Put it away, right now.
Simmer down, Vex.
We can't afford to lose our heads. We need to calm down and focus.
Calm down, Vex.
Do what he says, Vex. This ain't helping right there.
Fine. We do it your way. For now.
She is mad. Watch the She's so mad.
If you see Mercer, come tell me right away.
What about us? What are we doing? Brian, tell me.
Before I help you track Mercer down, I need to know what you learned from Carlia. I mean, everything.
We learned lots of things. It was Mercer that killed Gallus, not Carlia.
That was the case. From that last entry in Gallus's diary, it looks like he was getting close to exposing Mercer to the guild.
I feel like so many of these people die without just... They should just say that, you know, I have this feeling, this suspicion, but instead they need to get all this info together.
But I always assumed they were just a tale.
I actually didn't mean to click that one. I meant to click the one below.
Is there anything else she told you?
Because I wasn't sure if we wanted to tell him about the Nightingales, or we can tell him that she was behind these.
Clever lass. Was there anything else?
Nope, that's everything.
Then I have an important task for you. I need you to break into Mercer's home and search for anything that could tell us where he's gone.
Yes, we can rob Mercer.
A gift from the Blackbriars after they kicked the previous family out. A place called Riftwheel Manor.
The thing is, we're not going to be very good at sneaking and breaking in because we are not very good thieves. Vold guards it. Okay.
Be careful, lass. This is the last place in Skyrim I'd ever want to send you.
Why is this Vold guy really scary?
Get the information and leave. And you have permission to kill anyone that stands in your way.
We've got a license to kill. We are literally James Bond for this one. What's the best way to get in?
Good question. I've only set foot inside a few times myself. And that was in Mercer's company. If you can get past his trained watchdog...
He's got a watchdog.
Your best bet might be the ramp to the second floor balcony in his backyard.
Wait, is this an actual watchdog or is this that Vald person?
It's some sort of crazy contraption Mercer commissioned for quick escapes.
Okay.
I'd wager a well-placed shot at the ramp's mechanism would lure it in a hurry.
Okay, so we've got to shoot a ramp. And what about this watchdog? What's my torch has just run out.
A real piece of work, that one. Mercer's holding something over his head.
Oh.
Keeping him loyal.
I thought you meant an actual dog. I'm like, I'm not going to shoot a dog. I'm not going to shoot a dog.
If you catch my meaning.
Okay, so Vex used to have a thing with this blood guy. She's a pretty girl, so he must be a handsome guy. But let's go and figure out the way to get past him. I wonder if she's still seething mad as well. Okay, Vex, can you help us, hun? Brian says you have info on Vald.
That pig. Oh, I have info on him.
Oh, he's wronged her. He's definitely wronged her.
Vald, good side. I think you have the wrong person. The only thing Vald understands is gold. A man after my own heart.
Wow, so you need to buy him off.
For a whole lot. I mean, you are asking him to betray Mercer Frey. Your best bet would be to erase his debt with Maven Blackbriar.
Oh, we're gonna have to talk to Maven Blackbriar. I'd rather just kill the guy than speak to her. You know what? You know what? He's wronged Vex, and Vex is one of our friends. And he sounds like a bit of a douche, this guy. He's wronged Vex, and I don't want to pay him off. And I don't want to get rid of his debts. So that leaves one option, guys, and that's to kill him. So that's what we're going to do. Oh, we can get back out this way again. Maybe it will stop Vex being so mean to us as well. That's him. That's the guy. Oh, man. Vex, what were you thinking? Vex, no. Come on. You can do better than that. I can't see this mechanism thing that I'm meant to shoot down, to be honest. Oh, look, look, look. There it is. There's a little, like, walkboard up there. Okay, let's try and get a better angle of it. Right, let's see if we can get shot in. Lydia, mind your big screwball head. Yeah! But I did tell you to mind your head. She's doing that. Okay. So we've got the fast escape. Now we just need to get inside. What? What? What's happening? Lydia's fighting someone. I don't even know where she is. She's fighting Vlad. Oh, Vald or whatever he's called. So Lydia's just gone in. How on earth can we get in? I don't know how Lydia's fighting him. The gate's open. The gate is wide open. What? Look, here's our little access. You are out of lockpicks. Damn. Okay. I need to go buy some lockpicks. But we've got our sneaky way in. So that little arrow shot worked. I have no idea why the gate was open though. Lydia was up to something then. She's got friends in high places that she's not told me about. Weirdly enough, she's not here with me though. So she's either trapped. Oh, here she is. Here she is. Lydia, yes. They all said I was silly for keeping you around, but she's proved herself there. Okay, I'm back. I have lockpicks now. This is an expert lock though. It's not a master. So hopefully we should be able to do it. It's much harder when you've got... Did it first time! When you've got cat hair in your mouth. Definitely does not help the situation. Okay, discover evidence of Mercer's location. Do you think there's other people in the house? What? Who's just unsheathed? Who said, huh? Oh, there's bandits singing in here. Lydia, you might have to wait here.
I'm right behind you. As you wish, my...
Where are you going?
Turn down for what?
What is she doing? I tell her to wait there and she just walks straight in. Lydia, you scoundrel. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. I can just hear bandits dying left, right, and center. Lydia is just a powerhouse. Oh my god, Lydia. Actually can't handle her. She's insane. I was trying so hard to be a little sneaky squirrel. Well, there's no point sneaking now, is there? We might as well just stand up and walk around. Right, since we're here, is there anything worth stealing? Because screw Mercer. Oh, a bandana, hello. Yes. Yes, we will be putting a bandana on later on. In fact, let's get one for Lydia as well. I don't know where Lydia's gone now. She just killed everybody and then she just left me. So this is little Mercer's house. If you ever wanted to know what the house of a traitor looked like, looks like this. Look at this, he's got apple pies, treats, sweet rolls. The guy's got a sweet tooth. Okay, we're gonna give Lydia a bandana. There we go, look at that. Lydia with a little bandana. You look pretty badass, Lydia. Look at that. How badass do we both look with our bandanas? Let's go. Suspicious cabinet. There we go. False back panel. Thank God it was called Suspicious Cabinet, or else I never would have noticed that. Huh. Oh, here we go. I'm like, where now? What the hell? Little cape on the door. Okay, let's keep adventuring further in. Oh my gosh, that scared me. Okay, there's traps on the floor. Maybe Lydia goes first. Lydia?
I'm right behind you.
I need you to do something.
Yes, Thane. What is it? Yes, my Thane?
I need you to go over there.
Okay, got it.
Hey, she got straight across. No! Why? Why does it work on Lydia but not on me? Oh my gosh! There's traps everywhere! Okay, that I can see that trap. I can see that trap. Oh my gosh, can we turn these off? I don't think we can. There's no way to turn them off. Right, we're gonna have to just time this, I think. Run! Oh, I got hit by one, but it was fine. I could survive one. Oh, Lydia. Oh. I let her struggle on with that. She won't learn if I tell her. She has to learn on her own, really. Oh, there's a trap there. Unlock trap. Expert. Oh man, we're down to 7. Unlucky number 7. Boom. Okay, so that stopped whatever was going to try and jump out and kill me, luckily. Ah. Here we are. See what else is in here. Chilren display case. Hello, let's get into here. We'll take Chilren. Ooh, hello. A follower has died! She's died and now she's naked! Why is she naked? Why is she dead? I can't let her die. I can't let her die. She means too much to me. I'm gonna have to load. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna have to go all the way back to here. I just can't let her die. We've been through too much together. She always has my back. Okay, we're gonna have to go do this again. Okay, so we're back here without Lydia this time. I left her upstairs. I just can't. Ooh, Delvin wanted that. I just can't let her die. I know you guys don't like her, but I do. She's like, she's crazy and she just runs out and kills everybody, but she does it to protect me. And I have to give her that. Red kitchen reader, increased our sneaks. Take Mercer's plans. We need to go back to Brynjolf now. Let's just see if there's anything else worth taking in here. Hello, some little gifts to steal. Maybe we'll give one to our friend Lydia. Oh, look in here. Oh, you always take the bowl. Oh my gosh, we've got so much stuff. We're going to be loaded after this. Look, we can get back into the Ratway Vaults from here. That's handy. No wonder he could rob them blind. He just went through here to get them all. If only they knew. How cheeky. Very cheeky. Building it into your house. Gotta hand it to the guy. That was clever. I know he's actually called Brynjolf, by the way. I just like to call him Brian.
We scoured the town and I've spoken to everyone.
I think he looks a little bit like Mercer. I found him. Found his plans.
He's going after the eyes of
it looks a bit like Ned Stark.
That was Gallus's pet project. If he gets his hands on them, you can be certain he'll be gone for good and set up for life.
Oh my gosh, we have to stop him.
Agreed. He's taken everything the guild has left, and to go after one of the last greatest heists is just an insult.
The guy is such a jerk.
And made amends for how the guild's treated her. Now she wishes to speak with both of us. Quickly.
Let's go find her then.
No time to lose.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait to take him down. Where is she? She's over here.
Brynjolf, time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, decision falls to you.
Kill him.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision.
Kill him.
Tried to kill both. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
Yay!
Mercer is a nightingale, an agent of Nocturna.
Yeah, Ned Stark.
It's all true. Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal and the Twilight.
Yes.
He's got a bit of dust
That's
in his mouth.
We need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate is a small path cut up the mountainside.
Ooh.
At the end of that path is a clearing and an outstanding
sky. I think we're going to go to the Nightingale place. Yes, let's go. Okay, so we're back out into Skyrim. Lydia doesn't have a bandana since we loaded our save, so...
I am sworn
hopefully...
to carry your burdens.
Hey, when she says it, like... Oh. Will you wear this? Yay, there we go. It's not the same one as last time, but... You look pretty awesome, Lydia. Like, I feel like I look up to her. Like, she's tall. But then I am actually taller than her. So, heh. I don't really like that I'm like a green goblin, though. I can't wait for the script manager so you can change your character a little bit more. Okay, so we're gonna swim there. Is Lydia following us? No, she's not. Look at the cool little foxy! Oh, he's gone. He has gone. What's this? Look at this statue. It's like a plinthy thing. Nightingale Hall! She's gonna give us the armor, please! What is the significance of this place?
The headquarters of the Nightingales, cut into the mountainside by the first of our kind. We've come to seek the edge we need to defeat Mercer Frey.
Let me be with Nightingale.
If you'll follow me, I'll try to explain in a way.
Guys, I am excited. Come on, explain. Explain everything. Ned Stark's come along for the ride too. Harvests flowers because she walks slower than anyone I've ever known. Look at this place. So spooky.
When I joined the guild, but I never believed it existed.
The assumption that the Nightingales were just a myth was seeded within the guild on purpose.
So they are super, super secret, secret organization. The secret scrolls.
Trying to understand why I'm here, lass. I'm no priest. I'm certainly not religious. Why pick me?
So is it like a religious cult? No, it's not.
It's business.
It's a business cult. Okay. So here's their little headquarters. Lydia's impressed, so you know it's good.
It's been a...
Activate the armor stone, guys! It's happening! It's happening! Activate! Nightingale boots added! Nightingale armor added! Nightingale gloves added! Nightingale hood added! Oh my gosh, we've got it all! We've got it all! Look, here's how it looks. Bad ass armor. So the actual armor increases our stamina by 20, increases frost resistance by 15, 37 armor. So light armor as well. The boots muffle us and we move silently like secret squirrels. The Nightingale gloves lockpicking is 15% easier and one-handed attacks do 15% more damage, which is good because we use that bound sword. Or we can use our Nightingale sword as well. And then the Nightingale hood is illusion spells cost 12% less to cast. We don't actually have any of those at the moment, but that would be like invisibility and that kind of thing. So super, super perfect if you want to be... as a secret squirrel, basically. And here is how the armor looks when it's on.
Let's get this show on the road.
So badass. Like, it's... I think it's the best armor in the game. Like, look at it. It looks so cool. And it has a cape with it. And not much stuff in the game actually has a cape with it. So, look at that. I like how it keeps your fingers out as well for, like, doing thiefy things with your fingers. Lydia, I'm really sorry, but there was only one... I mean, I can try. No, I'm sorry, Lydia. You look very lovely in the armor you've got, though, so you just stay there, okay, hon? Oh, this is where they all sleep. It's lovely. I really want to find some more armor for Lydia. I want her to feel involved. I feel responsible for her because you all hate her so much. Okay, let's follow those guys. Oh, look! Ned Stark's got his armor on, too. You look pretty cool. Look at them all! Squad goals! Squad goals!
I appreciate the armor, but becoming a knight.
I am so tall.
To hold any hope of defeating Mercer, we must have Nocturnal at our backs.
So we need Nocturnal to help us. Is it a Daedric prince?
What sort of arrangement? I need to know the terms.
Basically, an otherworldly kind of entity.
Nocturnal will allow you
like
to become a knight.
Like a goddish kind of person, I believe.
Whatever you wish. And in return, both in life and in death, you must serve as a guardian of the Twilight Sepulchre.
So we serve her either, in, even in death.
But at this point, I suppose there isn't much to lose. If it means the end of Mercer Frey, you can count me in.
He didn't really get asked, did he? He's just like, you're a Nightingale now. Yes, I am. I am so ready.
After I open the gate, please stand on the circle.
That's enough to make your head spin, eh?
Oh, look at there's a crew of three of us. It's more friends than I've ever had.
I'll speak when the oath is complete.
I'll open this. I've got it. You can't use this. Okay, I'll stand back and watch. Lydia, I don't know if you can come forward into this, but I think you're just going to be a hindrance. Take the deal.
We'll speak when the oath is complete.
Still here.
Wait here, hun.
As you wish, my thane.
It's nothing personal. You're just not part of our gang.
Time's wasting, and Mercer's still out there. Let's get this show on the road.
So I have to go stand on the stone. Ooh, look at this. It's like Batman. I feel like Batman. So I'm on my stone. Lydia doesn't have a stone. Look at my little eyes glinting through. Ah, so cool.
Good on you, Lady Nocturnal, Queen of Murk and Empress of Shadow. Hear my voice.
I hear you. Look at Lydia down there. What is she doing?
I was wondering when I'd hear from you again.
She's pulling the string repeatedly. Okay, concentrate. Focus. Focus.
You're already mine, Carlyle. Your terms were struck long ago. What could you possibly offer me now?
I have two others that wish to transact the oath. To serve you both in life and in death.
I mean, this is a
you
pretty...
You surprise me,
that's
Carlyle.
A big ask.
This offer is definitely weighted in my favor.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I want this.
Revenge. How interesting. Very well. The conditions are acceptable. You may proceed.
What happens now? Just like some...
We accept you.
How do we get all our powers?
We dedicate ourselves to you as both your avengers and your sentinels. We will honor our agreement in this life and the next.
I never agreed to this, Carlyle.
Very well.
What have you dragged me into?
I name your initiates Nightingale. And I restore your status to the same, Carlyle.
No.
And in the future, I'd suggest you refrain from disappointing me again.
Ta-da. She is a forgiving yet harsh lord to serve. Speak to Carlyle. Carlyle, we did it. We became Nightingales for you.
Now that you've transacted the oath, it's time to reveal the final piece of the puzzle to you. Mercer's true crime.
Well, this just keeps getting deeper and deeper.
Mercer was able to unlock the guild's vault without two keys because of what he stole from the Twilight Sepulchre. The skeleton key.
You guys have mentioned this to me. It's the unbreakable lockpick.
Caused our luck to run dry.
So the key unlocks any door?
Yes. But the key isn't only restricted to physical barriers.
It can unlock the key to your heart.
The potential to wield great power securely sealed within our minds.
That's definitely less lame than what I said.
Access these traits, potential becomes limitless.
The guild should possess this item. Three of us could keep it. What about me? What about just I want it? I'll say the guild.
Although it would benefit the guild more than you can imagine, in the end, the key isn't returned to its lock in the Twilight Sepulchre, things will never be the same for the guild.
So we have to return it.
As time passed, our luck would diminish to the point of
it gives them luck.
And whether you know it or not, our uncanny luck defines our trade.
First time I ever set out to return something.
In our line of work, it's quite rare we set out to return a stolen item to its rightful owner.
It's not very thiefy, is it?
Before we depart, Brynjolf has some business to discuss. I suggest you.
So you guys told me to keep it because then I can unpick the lock to anything.
There's one last piece of
but if I do that, then I can't complete this quest line, guys. So I'm going to have to do it.
One last piece of business we need to settle.
I'm sorry. It's more important that I save the guilds. Why tell this to me?
Maya and I had a long discussion before you arrived
here.
Thanks to your efforts, Mercer's treachery has been exposed. After we deal with him, all that remains is restoring the guild to its full strength. As a result, we both feel that you have the potential of replacing Mercer as leader of the Thieves Guild.
I've been a thief for about 7 minutes and
I've
suck. But you're gonna make me the leader of the Thieves Guild.
I've stolen trinkets from nobles and framed priests.
I don't understand.
I'm good at what I do, maybe even one of the best. But it's all I know. I've never been one to lead. Never desired it, never cared for it.
What about Vex? She's a good little vex head. I don't know what to say. No, it's not right.
Look, everyone in the guild admires what you've done. Maybe they won't come out and simply tell you, but I promise you it's true.
They admire me.
Now they know Mercer never genuinely cared about the guild. He lacked the loyalty you obviously possess. I can't think of anyone better.
Well, if you say it like that, then
spoken like the leader of the Thieves Guild.
I didn't mean to use that option. The PC dialogue controls is so bad.
Before your coronation.
Oh, I accept.
It's decided. When this is all over and Delvin's contacts assure me that we've regained our footing in Skyrim, we'll handle the details. Until then, we have quite the task ahead.
Thanks, let's get to it.
Over the plans you brought us, and I'm convinced the eyes of the Falmer are in the dwarven ruins at Erkenfeld.
So we have to go Carlyle stop him from stealing the eyes of the Falmer.
This will be a fight to remember.
We've got to take down Mercer Frey. Yes. And look at us. Look at us go in our little cool armor. I feel sad for Lydia. She just keeps pulling that drawstring. Lydia, what are you doing? What? Oh, hon. She is not taking this whole Nightingale thing well. What?
Honor to you, my thing.
She's lost her mind. Lydia, follow me.
As you will, my thing.
Come on, we'll
protect you with my life.
We'll let you stand on a stone. We'll make you feel like you're part of it. Nobody wants to be left out. Come on, Lydia, come stand here with me. So guys, I'm gonna leave it there. We finally got the most badass armor in the whole game. I look super awesome. Lydia's not being part of the Nightingale gang very well, but I'm sure she'll get over it. She'll get over it. I really hope you enjoyed this episode. The next episode sounds like it's gonna be the epic finale. We're gonna go confront Mercer Frey once and for all with our little Nightingale like crew and Lydia. We're gonna go and stop her from stealing the eyes of the Falmer in the dwarven ruin. And yeah, it's gonna be a fight to remember. If you're looking forward to seeing that episode, please give this one a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments below what you think of the Nightingale armor. But for now, I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye.